Hey guys, welcome back to the Second Time Lucky Mining Channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at more helium antenna testing. More specifically, we're going to have a look at a 3 dBi outdoor antenna that I bought off Amazon and looking at my test results for the last 7 days. So what we'll be looking at is comparing it against the other antennas that I'm testing to sort of see and work out, you know, is this 3 dBi antenna actually worth it? If you like this type of content, hit the like button as it will help me out a great deal and potentially consider subscribing. But enough of a shameless plug for my channel, let's get into it. If you guys haven't watched my first video, I'll leave a link in the video description and tag it at the top, but a quick recap of my history. I bought a Bobcat 300 miner last year, and then looking at the deliveries, I quickly realized that there's a massive backlog and I'm probably not gonna get that miner anytime soon. Being that, I then started looking locally. I managed to find a SenseCap M1, again, not my first choice, but that's what I could get, and I bought it from a scalper. Since then, I then bought 5 antennas from Amazon mainly that I've been trying to test and compare and find out what is the best setup for me. And that's sort of what this video is about. So we're going to have a look at the 3rd antenna that I've been testing. But quickly, let me show you what my setup looks like upstairs. Alright, as you guys can see, this is the setup upstairs. So here I've got my gaming PC, it's currently mining Flux, and then Monero Ocean on the CPU, so that's that PC there. I've got my Raspberry Pi, what I'm busy doing at the moment is trying to host the Flux node, or busy with the testnet for the 1st of March. But anyway, I digress. So for Helium, there you can see I've got the antenna, again, the same place as last week, right at the top, and I'm using the Elgato camera stand to get it as high as possible. I also ended up going with the standard cable that came with it when I bought it from Amazon, so I didn't do the shorter cable. I just wanted to make sure that, you know, if anybody buys this, this is exactly what it looks like. Now, here you can see where I've got my SenseCap at the back. So there you can see it's at the back, the cable all the way there. So it's not a particularly long cable, but yeah, that's sort of what it looks like. But anyway, let's jump back in and have a look at the results. Okay, now that you've seen my dodgy setup upstairs, let's have a look at the results. More specifically, I want to compare the results of this 3 dBi antenna against the other 2 antennas that I've already tested. I don't know if you guys have watched those videos, but I'll leave a link in the video description and then tag them at the top. But we'll be comparing it against the 6 dBi McGill antenna that I tested last week, and then the 5.8 indoor antenna that I tested the prior week. Looking at the results, I'm happy to report that I managed to get 0.641 helium. Yes, I know there's lots of people that make a lot more than that, but for me, that is my best week and I'm super stoked about it. And it's more than any of the other 2 antennas that I've tested. From a witnesses point of view, so it's actually quite interesting. I managed to get less witnesses than the previous other 2 antennas that I've tested. And again, where I am from a location point of view, there's not a lot of helium hotspots really around me. Now, looking at the beacons, and this is probably why I think I actually managed to get more earnings. I managed to get 9 more beacons compared to what I did with the other 2 antennas. So that's actually quite good. So overall, I'm actually quite happy with the 3 dBi antenna results. As I mentioned, it's the most helium that I've made so far in the weekly buckets that I've tested it, but that's not really where my testing is stopping. And that leads me into what's sort of next. I still have another 3 dBi antenna, but I thought for this week's testing, I wanted to go long. So as I mentioned, you know, I am in the suburbs, in a big city here in Australia, and there's not really a lot of helium hotspots around me. There's a lot in the city, and I'm not actually witnessing any of them. Maybe one that is very tall, but not really. So what I'm planning for this week is to test a higher dBi antenna. So as I mentioned, I've got an 8 dBi antenna, so let me show you guys here, that I got off Amazon. So I'll leave a link in the video description to that, but this is sort of what it looks like. It's got a base station, so show you a little bit closer. This is a magnetic one. This cable is 3 meters long, and it's got this connector here. So let's see if I can show it to you guys. The zooming is not working nicely. There we go. So this is supposed to go into your helium hotspot, and then it has got this 8 dBi antenna. So let me show you here. That's what the connector looks like. So what I suspect what I'm going to be doing is just taking this specific antenna and sticking it straight into my Helium hotspot at the back, because I really don't need the three meter cable. I think that's a little bit of an overkill for me, and I have tested the standard SenseCap antenna that would work similarly and stick it in the window. So that's what I think I'm going to be doing for the week. So I'm quite curious to see if I use this 8 dBi antenna, if I can actually reach some of those hotspots in the city and potentially earn a lot more. So that's really the game plan for the week. That's it for this video, guys. If you're interested in the results, come circle back next week same time to have a look at how much have I earned using this 8 dBi antenna and then comparing it against the other antennas. But if you've liked the video, please like it and maybe consider subscribing. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.